It's not free. It might seem like it's free. It's not free.
Okay, yeah.
How many months ago is it? A third of the plant is on Facebook.
That's scary.
I mean, I can't even have them get my news from Facebook.
Right, I know.
40% of the people.
How do they get their news?
I don't know where the news is on Facebook, but obviously it's pretty like between People Magazine and the National Enquirer. They don't have any.
I like it because it makes it so easy to keep up with my grandchildren.
Absolutely.
But
that's
know,
not like that's not like news.
No, exactly.
That's something.
Well, but I have noticed that I've seen a lot of blocked content on Twitter.
And so you were following it enough to get it blocked.
No, I have a Twitter account, so I also follow a lot of other people's. But then some of the messages I get have the message say, you chose not to be included in this content. Did you get something like that before? No? Well, you're just not on it enough, maybe.
Yeah.
But I'm like,
more of an Instagram person.
Okay. But I'm like, you know, I never told you not to send me something. I never told you to block anything on my account. And, you know, it's some of the stuff is, you know, some of the anti-vaxxer stuff. And I'm like, I need to be informed what the anti-vaxxers are doing so I have the tools to fight it.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. You have to suffer through that.
Yeah. So, you know, it's sad that they block it for me when I didn't even ask it to be blocked.
There's a setting for that. I've tailored my Twitter account so I get exactly what I want and who I want. And
I have to have it a little bit wider open because I need to be in.
No, I agree. I'm glad I'm not in your position. If I was a police officer or something, I have to look at all these heinous crimes.
Right.
These criminals, I don't know if we can get much pleasure out of following criminal behavior and reading every post. It's like reading Donald Trump's post.
Oh, God.
The news guys were so relieved when they left because Biden doesn't release a tweet at 2 in the morning.
Right,
that
exactly.
That means every head of the news department around the world has to wake up and respond.
What a terrible job.
And no Friday afternoon firings since he started. You know, every Friday afternoon,
he'd
fire a bunch of
people. Oh, Trump?
Yeah.
So they just all out.
I don't know.
47% of Republicans
won re-election. Oh, yeah.
Which is only half of Republicans. The other half will probably vote for him.
Yes. Okay.
So it's not like he's got a big
following.
Oh, yeah, they're getting out there. It's like, I was talking this the other day, you know, vaccine knowledge in the 40s, late 40s and 50s, that was when a real surge in the U.S. to get people vaccinated.
Yes.
And people accepted it, they accepted all the problems.
No, they didn't either.
Well, they didn't. Just like they're not
like
accepting
today,
it now.
Yeah.
Just like today. I mean, I would think we'd hope we'd move the ball down a little bit, but maybe not.
No, not at all.
See, there you go. Back then, they must have thought they were a bunch of hillbillies or something.
It's really funny. So I visited my son in Montgomery County, Maryland, 2 weeks ago. It's the same county that NIH is in. It's the most diverse county in the U.S., and it is one of the most highly vaccinated, 97% vaccination rate for those over 12 years old. Huge! And everybody wears masks, even outside, and I'm like, whoa! Highly educated people, the home of NIH. And, you know, my son is a very high tech community as well. Yeah. He works for Boeing there as a computer engineer.
Was this today? I was hearing about how many police officers don't want to get vaccinated.
Yeah.
And well, understandably, there are probably some pretty hardliners in the police department. I mean, whether they're biased or what, just regular people. You know, a police officer is kind of a bully. You know, he is a police officer.
Narcissistic.
Well, let's hope not.
Come visit.
Oh, yeah.
But anyway, you're exactly right. It's tough to be
there.
A police officer.
Yeah.
So if you're up against criminals who are kind of smarty pants.
Too bad, like,
COVID and even like that guy the other day, the cripple, couldn't get out, they dragged him out of the car. and he had $22,000 and
she was
a lot of drugs in
his
system.
She keeps blaming it on herself.
But
well, you give her seconds and I'll get seconds.
She was supposed to take
please,
the same
help yourself.
Flight, like the same company or airline as me and my mom.
It's such a crazy world.
And my cousin's
I've been studying Tennessee Williams
never goes anywhere because their family, like...
Well, he was always cruising, for one thing, and he always went out. He always had that component of always going to the corner. And when you go to the corner in any city, you learn a lot of things you maybe never would learn.
He's 2 years older than me.
Most of it was all put in his place, plus the relationship.
But which is good. She's studying in Virginia now. She's at least getting out of her comfort zone.
Just go to Key West and hang out and find everybody and just hang out with people. He'd hang out in New York City, New Orleans, Rome. He spent a tremendous amount of time in Rome.
Plus every other
I have one of my favorite books. I have an original edition in the original dust jacket.
Wow.
This is the Rome Spring of Mrs. Stone.
Yeah, Warren Beatty was in that film.
There's a new one. Mm-hmm. It's not so new anymore, but it's new. Helen Mirren. It's fantastic. It's home box office. It's really good.
I was just watching Jessica Tandy and Alec Baldwin played Stanley. Jessica Tandy played Blanche. What a production. See these movies. Finally, there was such a beast in someone. In the play, raped her.
Yes, so now everybody
we're coming
to visit you.
Want to play the part
this
all
summer,
the way.
So this summer, we're going to have my aunt, uncle, there. My younger cousin.
Yeah, like a bully or,
Or even Blanche. You know, any female actress plays Blanche to the hilt. Everybody's going to think she's a
punk. Well, she had the tarantula arms.
Right. So anyway.
I think they're coming
she
at different times.
She just wasn't.
I had six adult family of six set. Adults.
Well, I think that's what Tennessee Williams is.
Even if they don't
know how to
drive.
That always gets you into trouble.
Or
fun.
I have two cars and two bikes, so take your pick.
I barely knew
Ivy.
Put it on my front burner. Never had any experience of going out. When I was going out,
That's all right.
Mother wife.
All that much stuff.
I think Candace Williams is very interesting.
One time I loved my van to a friend of mine.
A lot like I do now.
And she said, well, what are you going to do about a car? I'll catch a ride with somebody. She said, no, take Jeff's car.
What did I learn?
It was a Porsche.
Well,
I drove the Porsche for a couple of weeks while they were moving.
I did what I liked and did the best I could. And they didn't know anything more than you.
History is made.
So what if it's special? It turned into a big hit. Let's hope you don't kill yourself.
A later model would be nice, but it sounds good. It could have been.
Even if you were to make it?
It sounds good.
When Streetcar Named Desire hit the theaters,
I was so concerned.
Everybody overnight turned into a superstar.
So,
these are all a bunch of, I don't know.
Does it waste the next thing? Why do you have
Bradley Jessica Lee?
Yes,
He played it in the movie too.
Yeah. Alec Kazan, boy, he really could do something clean, sharp, got some words to it.
I actually have on my iPad, I've got Alex Murphy's score.
Yeah, right.
I use Streetcars and Project.
It's her.
Kids and they don't know who it is.
So Irene has this.
This all becomes 10 Pan Alley.
deep and study, like Tiny Tim was an expert in all the time. He was like massive. And Tiny Tim. And of course, Bob Dylan was something of a master, and they got along great. That's all. Well versed in the history of music.
That has been
or whatever their art is.
Not very memorable, but it just happened.
And it comes with the character.
It's
of course, in theater, you know, this is the funny thing about UC. The theater department will make up a history of this.
So well.
The history of the some obscure theater piece.
It's fun,
you know,
to
trap doors.
It handles so well.
And that'll qualify for the history
department. Yes.
Undergraduates. Have to take American.
We still make them take European history.
Well, good, I think.
And I teach a class with history of architecture.
You're
growing
old and happy.
It's possible that I'll do a crossover.
We have a theater department.
We might be able to work that out. Yeah,
you that's
driving me
and you're walking. UC doesn't have a theater department.
Now, how about this?
Oh, yes.
I saw it.
And took it and got a nice bouquet for somebody and kept it alive for the last couple of years.
From Helen's party.
We stretched them, and then I realized I could just hang them onto it. That's 24 feet, and that's 24 feet.
It's not my thing.
I got two strings, and there you go.
Did you have somebody who knows?
Yes,
it
is.
But
nice
sometimes,
effect.
Like, he's working from home
so
right
nice.
Now still.
Yeah.
And I sit on Norman's
birthday is the 9th of October.
Okay,
it's
just
pouring
through
your
shoes. Like, how do you sit there and do it all day? It's like washing your life on an Excel sheet.
I could do that. Yeah, I've done a bunch of